Okay, welcome everyone again. Today we'll show you how to quickly connect CPEs of Huawei. One of them is 8546M, of course in GPON. As a second device we have kind of a media converter, 8010, also from Huawei. At this moment on each there is loss, on these two. Okay. We connect everything to old MA5608T, equipped with GPBD card, which is 8 pons with SFP C+ modules, also with MCUD card, that is our uplink, and of course with power AC. To all these we also plug extra link splitter 1 to 8, it should be fine. Okay, let's do it. To start with, we won't show you how to log in via the console because probably everyone knows it. We log into the alt. Okay, firstly we'll run the internet on the uplink port. We won't discuss about VLANs here. I'm sorry, at the beginning we have to find all the cards that interest us. So, display. Board 0. These are all of our cards, that is GPBD, MCUD, uplink, and of course power. Next, board confirm 0. All slots, that is also the first one. And the second one. Okay, we've got it all. We have here small router from 1015 subclass, so we'll choose any free address. Interface. Let's configure the address. Let's choose, for example, 1015 0 207 255 3 times 0. And I think that should be fine. Of course the mask is standard. Okay, that's it. Now we need routing to make it all work. And I mean static routing, of course. And it's gonna be on the gateway 10.15.01. Okay, that's it. Now we have to create all the necessary profiles. The first profile is DBA, where we'll create 1 GB bandwidth. Add profile ID 10. Here 4. Of course we want maximum 1 GB, which is 1024 and 3 zeros. Okay, success. And now we'll open profiles we need for ONT devices. This will be a line profile. Of course, GPON. Profile ID set to 10, so we stick to it. Okay, DBA profile ID is still 10. And next step is to add GEM ports. Okay. Mapping. Of course, VLAN. Mapping to the GEM port. We have default VLAN 1. We didn't change that. We won't explain step by step what's going on exactly in these commands. You will find more details and descriptions of all the commands at www.antenne24.com. On the website there will be detailed explanation concerning which profile is for what and what these profiles actually are for. Next profile is the service profile for ONT. SRV profile, of course GPON. Profile ID is still 10. ONT port ETH1. Port VLAN ETH1. Okay. Success. Confirm. And quit. Okay, now we proceed to the GPON interface which interests us. In our case it will be interface GPON 0/1 because of the card which is number 1. This one, of course. Okay, now enable auto find of unregistered terminals on port 0 because we have connection under such PON. So port 0 ONT auto find enable. Now we can see all unregistered CPEs. Auto find on port 0. Okay, we have the first one. This one. Now we connect the second one. Of course, pawns are blinking because nothing hasn't been registered yet. Okay, so we have two unregistered Huawei devices right here. Let's register them right now. Okay, let's start with the first one from the top. ONT on port 0. ONT ID as first it will be 0. And we authenticate by DSN code. We can't forget about the profiles. ID 10. ONT SRV profile ID is still 10. And description Huawei 1. Okay, we've authenticated PON. It isn't blinking, but the light is permanent. Then to start the internet service, we also need to create a service port. And that is service port 1. VLAN 1. GPON 0/1/0 because this is this card, board 0, card 1, pawn 0. Okay, we go on. ONT 0. Gem port 1. Multi-service user VLAN 1. Okay, now let's see if this works. Okay, we've launched the internet. Of course, everything is in bridge mode. And we got addresses from the right subclass. We have internet. Great. Through this CPE. Okay. We've got one more to register. Let's see if we can register this one. Again, we enter the GPON interface 0/1 because we want this one. Display ONT autofind 0. We have one more because we already have registered the previous terminal, so let's do it. ONT confirm on port 0. ONT ID this time is the first, that is the second one. Then copy SN. Line profile ID, of course, 10. SRV profile ID, also 10. And description, Huawei 2. Success. Next step is to create another service port. Service port this time is the second one. VLAN on GPON 0/1/0. Because we are still using card 1, board 0, and pawn 0. Okay, now ONT is going to be with number 1 because here is another ID. Gem port 1, multi-service user VLAN, of course, 1. Now let's check our CPE. As you can see, the port has already stopped blinking. It's constantly green. It means that CPE has been registered on our alt. So let's quickly check whether we'll have the internet by DHCP. We immediately got it. Maybe we can show it again. After unplugging the cable, there's no connection, as you can see. When we plug it in, LAN diode is glowing. We immediately get address by DHCP. Of course, from the subclass we want, that is 1015. And now we verify if we have internet. And success, we have the internet. In this simple way you can connect Huawei CPEs to the old. In this short movie it will be all. And in the next one we'll show you how to connect NanoG to the Huawei old in a similar way. Don't forget to subscribe our channel. And thank you, see you again in next movie.